myself Dr. Sanjay P. Shukla. As we are doing series of lecture about how to treat ourselves without medicine. In first part, we discuss who are you and how universe and human are interconnected. We discuss there are three basic function of cell, that is production, protection and destruction, and we do the same things and each and every level means produce, protect and get destroyed by himself. In the part 2, we talk about the formation of disease, where we talk about how the disturbance in the three basic function of cell express itself at physical, mental level in the form of pathology. And this is decided by your genetic makeup and various other factors trigger these changes, like suppress emotions. It become normal to suppress emotions. Suppress emotion can become subconscious emotions and can literally run a show in the background without our conscious awareness. Emotions, both conscious and subconscious, are mirrored on a biological level. We also understand different individuals get different diseases due to our genetic makeup. Negative and absent emotions can impact your weakest point. A person with weak liver will develop a hepatic complaint, where a person with weak heart will have cardiac morbidities. Thus, we can say body manifests what goes on in the mind. The word disease is often associated with elements. However, it points to a state of disease both in body and mind. Mind is also so powerful that it can create any sickness in the body. This is hard to believe, but true. Even scientific research today is proving what our sages say millennia ago. Therefore, a diseased body could be an indication that the mind is not an ease, and this factor need to be first addressed. An agitated, confused, unhealthy mind lay the foundations of disease. Thus, several diseases once thought to be merely physical dysfunctions has been found to be psychosomatic in origin. Thus, we can conclude that disease is nothing but a state of delusions, and thus cure is nothing but getting aware of these delusions. In this part, we can talk about curing these stages without medicines. This problem can be classified into three main states. One is childhood, second is adolescence, and third is adult and old age. The first, children. Most of the children born today are hyperactive. This hyperactive child is due to state of mother during pregnancy, is not at peace. She is stressed during this period, which is reflected in the nature of baby. Thus, in ancient time, garbh sanskar was done during pregnancy. Such practice can make the mother relax, and thus the baby will be more calm and healthy. Second stage is adolescent stage. Here, they are not ready to listen and think they are always right and getting dominated by their parents. As adolescent children, they are full of energy, but this energy is mostly directed in wrong directions. If this energy is directed in right direction, it will not only make the person peaceful and reduce the chance of formations of pathology, but also change the country and whole world. Such an awareness can be created by involving them in various activity that enhance their spiritual growth and make them look inward rather than focusing on outer materialistic world. It's good if these children communicate with their parents and other family members about their issue. This can help a lot. Third, that is old age. Here, they have forsaken feeling, a feeling not being looked by ones for whom they have devoted their life, that is their children's. This feeling can be addressed if they understand that we get what we sow. If you have not instilled the value of integrity in your young ones in their early stage, these are not going to sow compassion toward you when they are grown up. This can be solved with the help of communication between family member and developing understanding in both generations. This awareness will make you free from expectation, and once you become aware of your false perceptions, many pathologies can be prevented. Younger generations should also understand the need of their elder and give appropriate time to understand their issues by communicating to ease their life, and by doing this, we can prevent many of a pathology before its formations. So it's proof that healthy mind is a healthy body, and for healthy mind and healthy body, you should be always awareness. You will be free from false perceptions, that is delusions. When the mind is able to remain calm, quiet and balanced in any situations, then even if the body is unwell, it is able to heal itself. Even terminally ill patients undergo spontaneous remissions once they work at cultivating a healthy, stress-free mind. Their immunity could get boosted, so the response to chemotherapy and any drugs improve dramatically. So now we understand awareness is the peace. So how to be in the peace? In the chapter 2nd, verse 70, in Bhagavad Gita, God Krishna had said, Apuryamanam achal pratishtham samudra ape pravisanti adavat tadavat kamayam pravishanti sarve sasanti apnoti na kaman kami. It translations as the water of different river enter the great oceans, which though full on all sides remain undisturbed. Likewise, a person who is not disturbed by the incessant flow of desire can alone achieve peace, and not the man who run after these desire and strives to satisfy these desire. Other auxiliary measures which bring in our life awareness are meditations, yoga, diet and lifestyle changes. Changes in surrounding environment, both physical and biological level. Identify and change habits or pattern which deteriorate your health, and developing new one which promote the healthy state in you. By taking all these measures, one can develop a healthy state both at mental and physical level and bring awareness and get cure. So conclusion is that awareness is the cure. We have anxiety, fear, feelings, false perceptions till we remain in the state of our false perceptions or delusion. These delusions create the pathology and disturb our system at mental and physical level. The only way to get rid of these is getting aware of our inner self, and only path to ultimate cure. Mostly an individual can come to state awareness by himself, but sometime they need help. Sometime they need professional help to guide in this process. One should never hesitate to ask for help or to discuss their issue with their concerned physicians. We from Sri Ganesh Homeopathic Hospital always ready to help in such situations. So if you have any issue in which you are not able to come out, please call us on this number. Thank you.